Welcome student, in previous lecture we discuss about the average value and average mean and RMS value of EMF or voltage and current. Now the next article from this topic AC circuit, that is a phasor. So what is the phasor? Phasors are a rotating vectors, that represents the quantity varying sinusoidally with the time. It is called as a phasor, and diagram representing is called as a phasor diagram. We see the connection between circular motion and a oscillatory motion or sinusoidal motion in previous topics. So if these rotating vectors, which represents the sinusoidally varying the AC values of current and voltage, that rotating vectors are called as a phasors. So I show one animation from a net. I thankful for that provider or websites. So here the variation is a sinusoidal. I hope that you see this. So this vector rotates, and if it is connected with a linear motion, then this variation is a sinusoidal and this variation is a circular. This rotating vector is called as a phasor. So here there is only one vector. There may be two vectors. One represents voltage and one represents current. So see the another animation. So here there are two vectors, rotating vectors. One is indicated by blue color and other is by red color, and there is a phase angle between that two vectors. So one quantity may be current and other quantity may be of a voltage. So these are rotating vectors which represents the quantity varying sinusoidally with the time is called as a phasor, and the diagram representing it is called as a phasor diagram. So let us see, what do you mean by phasor? So next article 13.4, that is a phasor. If we represent the alternating current and alternating EMF as a rotating vector with an angle between them is equal to phase difference between the current and EMF, these rotating vectors are called as a phasors. So phasors are a rotating vector. We represent the sinusoidally varying voltage and current, and the diagram representing them is called as a phasor diagram. So with the help of phasor diagram, it is easy to know the vector sum of current and voltage. The projection of this vector is fixed on a fixed axis, gives the instantaneous values of alternating current and voltage. We see in the next figure. Suppose this is a fixed axis, x-axis, this is y-axis, and if we represent a current, the length of this vector is the peak value. Suppose the current has a peak value, that is a I0, and this vector is anti-clockwise, and the angle between them is a phase, that may be omega t or omega t plus alpha, that is a phase angle, and they rotates. The projection of this gives the instantaneous value of current. Suppose this is the instantaneous value of current, that is I. If we take the projection on x-axis, this also gives an instantaneous value, but this value is I0 sin omega t, this value is a I0 cos omega t. So it will be discussed in the next slide. So here this is the figure which I have drawn. This is x-axis, this is y-axis. These are the two diagrams, two phasor diagrams. Now we see in details. Here phasor diagram rotates anti-clockwise sense. So phasor is a rotating vector. Suppose this is a phasor representing the current. The length of this vector is represent the peak value of current. I draw two graphs for sake of convenience. Suppose this is I0. The length of that rotating vector represents the peak value of current, and these are in a anticlockwise sense. These vectors rotates with a anticlockwise sense with a angular frequency omega. In sine form, the projection is taken on a x-axis. Suppose this is figure A. If we take their projection on the y-axis, then this value gives I that is equal to I0 sine omega t. So this represents the value, instantaneous value, I that is equal to I0 sine omega t. Instead of current, if there is a voltage, then it will be represented as a E0 sine omega t. So the projection of phasor diagram on a y-axis gives a sinusoidal values, that is I that is equal to I0 sine omega t, or E that is equal to E0 sine omega t. We may take their projection on a x-axis. If we take their projection on a x-axis, suppose this is a phase angle omega t, that will not show in figure, then this value gives a instantaneous value I, and which is given by equation I0 cos omega t. This is figure B. So the projection of phasor diagrams or rotating vectors on the x-axis gives the cosine value such as I that is equal to I0 cos omega t and E that is equal to E0 cos omega t. So there are two values, one along the y-axis, I0 sin omega t, E0 sin omega t, and one along the x-axis projection, that is I0 cos omega t and E0 cos omega t. So phasors are inclined with the horizontal by angle omega t or omega t plus alpha. If we show the both vectors E and I simultaneously, then they may be in phase or there may be some phase angle. So their projection will be either omega t or omega t plus alpha. The study of AC circuit is much simplified. What is its advantages? If we represent alternating current and alternating EMF as a rotating vector called as a phasor. So that animation, this rotating vector is called as a phasor. So here there are two vectors, one indicated by blue ink, other is indicated by red ink. One may be represented as a current, other may be represented as a voltage, and the angle between them is the phase angle between E and I. Let us see in further articles. So this is about the phasor diagram. So phasor diagram are a rotating vectors which makes the AC circuits more simplified. That is, they are rotating vectors, rotating in an anticlockwise sense. Their angle of inclination with a fixed axis gives the phase angle. The length of that phasor gives the peak value of either voltage or current, and their projection on a y-axis gives the sine values, and their projection on a x-axis gives the cosine values. So this is about the phasor diagram. We stop here.